Welcome to a new test and teardown video. This time it's another Heathkit model V-7A. So this is a vacuum tube voltmeter. As you can see, it's written here in the display. This one consists of two tubes, a dual diode and a dual triode. So I have to open this before I try and power it up. It is in a very, very bad mechanical state here. Look at that. It's all cracked and stuff. And it's kind of falling off all the time. And if I'm not mistaken, there's also a battery in here. And that is used for zeroing the ohms, if I'm not... Yeah... So every time I hear something about a battery, I always start to get really, really scared. So that's why I need to open and inspect. Yeah. This one have definitely seen some years. It's about, I think it's from 1956 to 1961, this model. So, I mean, obviously it's not new in any way, right? Yeah, there is a battery in there. Oh no. Who makes designs like this? Amen. How annoying. Of course, the American plug would definitely fit through that hole. And of course, where's the limit? I mean, should they have a hole like this big so also the English plug could go through? I don't think so. So obviously it's our problem for using plugs that is a little bit bigger than the original US kind of type. So here inside we can see the two tubes. Let's get some air here. I don't see any big nasty leaks. So that is not so bad at all. It's actually quite beautiful the way that it's made. Oops, what is that? There is a resistor here that is definitely cracked. That can't be good. So I don't expect all the ranges to work. Ooh, have you seen those contacts? Oy. That is not so good either. Yeah, this is definitely really, really old and crusty. Huh. But it's not, super, super bad. I mean, no. So there's supposed to be a lamp right here, and there's supposed to be a little hole that shines up here, but normally you have a little red dot here, so I think you only got light up there. That is something I hope that works. Look at that big wire sticking through that board. What the heck is that? I mean, somebody's not always paying attention to what they're doing and sticking wires all that way through. Yeah, but that is... How are you supposed to take this out? I really don't like designs with a built-in battery like that. Ooh. Very cute little transformer. So here's the, the way that it looks like that is also probably not too good either, right? Is it supposed to look like that? I Do we dare to plug this in? I'm probably going to have a new mains failure. Oh yeah, by the way that this is made in the rectifier here, there's only one diode. And isn't it that one? Yes, that is the diode. Right. So there's only one diode that creates the high voltage. Not even a bridge. That is so cute. And then of course we got those. The 12AU7 dual triode, and that is the little dual diode. Oh, we got a little name here. So who owned this one back in the old days? I see some corrosion down here. But yeah, we should probably just remove that battery and see if it powers up. It's actually not as bad as it could have been. Is this the original battery? See, we even got corrosion going through the metal can here. That's just a positive leak. No leaks at the negative. And I see 078 written here. So is this 78? Is it that old? Wow, man. So it's what? 45 years old. Oh, lovely. So there's of course a little bit of corrosion and nastiness down there, but this is really not as bad as I was crying about to begin with. So I feel that this is okay. I think I can power it up. I'm a little bit worried about this rectifier diode, if that is any good. And what is this doing? Yeah. So I feel I'm ready to try and power this up. Maybe I should dim the light a little bit here, because what we want to see is a little bit of light in the tubes. I left the switch in DC mode. And then I'll just plug in my mains and then hope for the best. I got light exactly as I was expecting. 14 watts is the power usage. Okay, I see a little bit of filament in that one. So that is not so bad. Some of those diodes you really can't see the filament, but I think I can actually see a little bit in that one. So that is good. So in DC mode, we should be able to turn that one, yeah? So that is annoying, it goes. Okay. That is not bad. It is possible to put it to zero. Ooh, it's... Well, maybe it's just a pot. Oh, I think it actually works a little bit. So now I'm DC positive, and that will be 50 volts, right? So I think I am using that scale here, and I tried to adjust it to zero. It's a little bit tricky. And this is 10. No, it is 11. Okay, let's give it 10. And then what? It's not exactly 10, huh? Let's try and crank it up to 20. Why is that happening? So it's definitely not reading. So that's 20 and then back to zero. Ooh, okay, so. Yeah, we have probably a... Yeah, it looks like we have a... Yep, we have a stock meter. So there's also a mechanical. issue. Yeah, and this is of course why somebody threw this out. Dealing with those mechanical issues, it's just not so easy. And also, it's probably been hammered all the way positive and negative, so it can also be broken in the coils and all that. Okay, I'll see what I can do. So my biggest problem was actually a mechanical issue with the meter itself. So here's what I am in, I'm doing. I'm now in 5 volt DC mode, and I'm applying 4 volt again and again. And then I see that the needle returns to the exact zero mark. Let me see if I can get some air in here or some light, right? And then Of course, I took all this apart and assembled it again, and I think that that is exactly what it took to solve this. I don't have a stock needle anymore, so that means I can assemble it. By the way, this cracked resistor that I talked about earlier, let me show you. It is right here. So that cracked resistor, where the heck was that? Oh, I have to be very careful now. See that one? So this is 9.1 ohms. And that is, of course, only for the resistance ranges. So it's not super important. But it is actually working. It don't look beautiful, but it is working. And my other problem with this unit is AC. So AC, it measures under half of what it is supposed to. So I think there's definitely something wrong with the with that rectifier diode. That is just impossible to replace. So other than that, I think I just don't use it for AC. I'm also going to check out if this selenium rectifier is causing any kind of problems. Let's see if we can see that. So no, that is ice cold. The capacitor here is ice cold. The transformer is actually quite warm, 53, and of course the tube is nice and warm. And that is the power on bulb. Wow, 100 and something for the, is it that really so? Oh my. Ow, that is insanely hot. So that's using all the power. Holy moly, that is burning hot. That is... There's normally no need to double check. If the camera says this, don't touch. I think that explains. My power usage is 10 watts, and the transformer gets quite warm. So that bulb, my goodness, is using all the power. That is a little bit crazy. Maybe I should try and just remove that or put in an LED instead. So, I think I managed to figure all this out. I'm now in AC, 5 volt, full range, and this is my zero. Well, it's all about trying to adjust this, it's a little bit aggressive. So that is my zero. So if it's 5 volt full range, it will be that one, right? So 4 volt is there, right? And now I got 4 volts. And it's spot on. And if I repeat this a million times, it repeats itself more or less to the last millimeter, I guess. So yeah, Now AC and DC and everything is working again. Haha! So it was all mechanical issues in here. And that is super nice. So I'm quite happy about that. It is back to life. Yes, about this very warm bulb. It's actually using 2 watts. So, but it's difficult to replace. I need to take apart everything. They made it so you can't unscrew that bulb. That is a little bit stupid. Why add this black isolation stuff? The case is made of metal. It's not going to harm anybody if it shines out to all over the place, right? Well, I don't have any more cool to say about this unit. I'm a little bit sad about this this glass that is very, very broken, and there's nothing to do about that. All I have to do is wait until I get another heat kit with the same kind of glass and where everything else is broken so I can replace this. I need to add tiny little drops of contact glue, I guess, in the corners. And this way it will stay on like it is, and I think that is okay. At least it's not gonna get more broken if it's not getting out, and it's not gonna break the needle and then and stuff like that. I know to take good care of it. So thank you very much for watching. I hope you had a little bit of fun. I hope to see you soon again. That's my screwdriver for AC calibration. Oops, carefully take that one out. It's all in the manual about how to calibrate and adjust all that. I don't want to put in a new battery. I prefer batteries to be out. See here, the power switch was broken and it's repaired with this wire. That is funny.